Up, y'all. It's your guy Rob Hollow Avarice, and we're back again with our gameplay of Assassin's Creed Valhalla. We did a lot of exploration last time. Not a lot of story. So we will dive on in and continue the story today. All right, we are heading to King Harald's Althing, which is probably going to be great. There's probably going to be nothing going wrong with it. Come on. Sorry, it's been a day. So we get a nice long loading screen to relax to. All right. All right, we're ready. So let's see, I did a little exploration off camera, I explored this area, and I finished like the games and stuff down here, where I demolished. So we're going to make our way over to the Althing. I just wanted to save here in case this is anything of importance. So it's been... So it's been a few days since I've played this, but... Oh, boy. We're over the entrance to a cave. That's not good. No, it's just been an interesting day at work. We are virtual again, like it's 2020 over here. So it's been a thing, and I gotta go get tested tomorrow. Feeling all right, just precautionary.
So, go on. Try it yourself, Eivor. Come. Stand here and look out over the fjords. Hold my hand.
There you go.
I've never been so high.
Your father brought me here long ago, when we were just 19 winters. Together we stacked stones into cairns.
These?
Yes. Think of this as a test of mind and wit. Stack the cairn stones high and wide into any shape you like.
How do I win?
You win by playing, and a quiet mind is your reward.
All right.
Let the air and nature's beauty soothe you.
Validate me! I've built a cairn. Hey. So that's this, their version of a puzzle, I guess.
Hmm.
Thanks for the opal, guy. Neat. A snake bite sail. Ooh. Fun. How festive. I'm glad all these people died here and gave me all this stuff. Yeah, so that's what's going on with me. So I gotta be tested tomorrow morning and not allowed back in the building until I do. But it's the week of Thanksgiving during the filming of this to reveal when this is being made, whenever this goes up on YouTube. On Twitch, it goes up today because I'm on Twitch. But whenever this goes up on YouTube, I'm revealing, yeah, this is filming the week of Thanksgiving, which means we're only there Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Give me your horns, no? Give me the leather. Any antlers? Still waiting on antlers. Still trying to get just some antlers from these boys. All right. If not, I can get leather at least. This is another eat a mushroom, get highs, and trip. Yeah. Yeah, so our Mondays are always a really easy day, so we had to miss Monday. Defeat the enemy while hallucinating. What the hell? What the actual hell? You know what? I'm in an area that requires a power of 280, and I have, like, a power of 12. So, you know what? We'll just mark it and remember it for another time. Because... ooh, boy. We are not ready for that. Yeah, so Mondays are always a very easy day for us. Tuesday, since it's the week of Thanksgiving, was going to be a party, a Thanksgiving feast in the building, which takes up a good chunk of the day, so that would have been a nice easy day. And Wednesday was a half day, and then we have all Thursday and Friday. So if there was ever a week where it was unnecessary to work from home to get an easy day or easy week, this is not the week. I would much rather be here this week and dealing with this crap during a full, packed, busy week. C'est la vie. That is life. Holy crap. Oh my, he's so powerful. Thank gosh. Well, I'm out of arrows, and there's three wolves there. So, four wolves there. Yeah. Bit of a stalemate. You know what? I'm gonna run like a coward for now. That one had an arrow at him, right? Try this. I know I got two more jars on the other side, so I can try and save a... Why did I go in there? I am just the biggest of fools. Hey, I would love to leave the wolves alone. They started this. The wolves started this war. I don't want to fight the wolves. I am in an area that is a suggested power of 280, and I have a total power of 25. I am so much weaker than these wolves. I can only win by ambushing right now. I would love to leave these wolves alone if they would leave me alone. I think they're gone anyway. I think... The foxes I'm fine with, I'll leave the foxes alone. But if those wolves weren't wrecking me, I would have much preferred to not fight them. Use all that to heal up.
Too cold. My blood freezes.
Yep. It's brisk. You're fine. I say as ice literally forms on me.
Turn to ice if I stay here.
Alright, I think we're good. What am I doing? Why would I unmark that from my map? Thank God, arrows. We were running low. Nope, they're foxes. We're good. Let's see, the very last thing I could do is go to the top of that mountain and get the last synchronization spot before I continue the story. But nah. We're clearly going to be back here late game, so let's... These enemies... They are, I'm just gonna ride right past... Excuse me, guys. Alright, they didn't attack me. We're good. Go up there, take the bridge, and get up there. Oh, well. I mean, there are a lot of things here marked as enemies, which is... probably fine, right? We're probably okay.
My love for you rises tall and strong.
Does everyone in Alrekstadir play their love game so loudly?
No, it's just my husband. He cannot satisfy his wife!
Alright. Old age.
No, he's still young and fit. It was not always so. He could not keep us apart when we were raiding.
He would plow you during raids.
Our first time was in the middle of a burning village. After a while, the crew made us stop. They said it was distracting.
Understandable.
Love can burn brighter near death. Have you tried revisiting these memories?
Yeah.
I could set your house on fire.
Talking about it is not the same. I need to feel it. Smell it.
So you need to bring the excitement of the raid into your bed.
You could help us pretend we are raiding. That will make my water flow. Come, we must tell my husband.
I was only a... well, all right.
Grab your weapon, you big, strong Vikinger. Today we raid.
A raid? Now?
Join me in the blood dance. Fill me with your battle lust.
Oh, yes, yes. Let us go, Viking. Maybe you could start by breaking things.
Scream as you do, like it is really happening.
It is amusing, but not arousing.
Yeah, it does not feel real enough.
Maybe you need more fire, like your first time.
Yes! Burn down our house! Burn it to the ground!
I was joking. I was like fully joking, y'all.
I am as hard as Heimdall's tower.
Then ram me like the Valgrind's gates and enter Valhalla. Take all plunder you want, Vikingar. And take us also and let the love hunger consume you.
Another time, maybe. But I will help myself to your chest.
All right. That was a world event. And because the PS5 records every time you get an achievement, and I just got an achievement for doing a 10th world event, that will always be recorded. That nightmare will always be recorded on my PS5. Get down there. Now where, how the hell, there we go. See, again, like, I don't want to complain too much about this game, but it just seems weirdly lifeless compared to some of the cities of grander scale. Harald seeks warriors. I've seen that note before. Speak with Gunthor. So it's not a evil area, it's a distrust area. Yeah, I'm actually gonna go back to where I started. So it's not like a they're on to me notification, it's distrust. Why do you distrust me so? Right? That's I mean, like, hey, I have no reason not to take King Harald at his word, but I've been saying every Assassin's Creed game is built around a quest for vengeance and betrayal. And that ain't happened to us yet, so Come on, come on. Almost got it. Almost got it. Oh, it's triangle, not square.
Your clan is a foul stench. We are strong.
Oh, this is where I have to go, actually. My bad.
You have just won your heart's desire, Eivor. Yet by the look on your face, you have lost your will to live.
Gorm is here with the last of his men. Why does that troll dare to show his face?
Leave it for another day. We are here under Harald's truce. And Gorm is too weak to try anything bold.
Gorm, the son of...
He's a seed stain on his father's trousers. We should wipe him from this world.
Kjotve the Cruel.
Not tonight, Eivor. Leave it.
Got it.
Basim, watch over this one. And see that she warms herself with drink. I will find my father and escort him to the longhouse.
As you wish.
Is Hytham well?
He will heal, but never fully recover. It is fortunate that you were able to succeed where he failed.
I mean, obviously.
My soul was strong.
When you slew Kjotve, did you see a sigil on him? Silver, the size of my palm, bearing the symbol of an ash tree?
Take it. Trade it for what you can.
I know where Gorm is camped. If you wish to see him without anyone the wiser, there is a trick I can teach you.
Already looking for another apprentice? All right, I'll bite. What do I do?
Use your cloak to obscure your face. Blend into the crowd. Divert attention.
Is this our walking with the monks?
In plain sight.
A gift of knowledge from a man I hardly know. Is this your way of asking me to join your brotherhood?
Not at all. So long as men and women fight to secure honor and freedom, religion hardly matters to me.
I suppose there's no shame in using deception when honor is at stake, and Gorm is a stain on that honor.
Then let's see what can be done to cleanse that stain. Give it a try. A few things you should know before you step into his camp. Walking unseen through hostile territory is an exercise in subtlety.
I mean, this makes sense. I am a brutal warlike Viking, and I think, because I spent the entire last game... I'm just gonna let the animus choose. The animus chooses female for now. No, can't do any upgrades right now. But I do have a bunch of runes that I could set though.
Dismissed at a distance.
HUD makes
Remain
you forgettable.
Far from watchful eyes, and you will be invisible to them. Do not draw blade or hammer, for these and other sudden movements can break your disguise.
Like hopping a fence?
And in case I wasn't clear, you will need to put up your hood for the trick to work.
My hood is up.
Is there.
in the camp ahead.
How do I put my hood up or down? Hence why it was a distrust zone. Gotcha.
What were you thinking? Drinking mead on an empty stomach?
You have to eat something before drinking that much.
How does that go? Feed before me.
I have some roasted lamb on the spit. Are you coming?
I don't know why, and then my cloak automatically disappeared, my hood. Let's go back 2 minutes. Again, that was really weird, right? I didn't make any... I mean, I accidentally ran for a split second there, but...
Gorm is there, in the camp ahead.
So my cloak was up.
What were you thinking? Drinking mead on an empty stomach?
You have to eat something before drinking that much.
How does that go? Feed before me.
I have some roasted lamb on the spit. Are you coming?
Unless, did the game want me to enter right through the front? Yeah, I'm not seeing any, It's a confidence game, right? As long as you act like you belong.
Evil! You Arker shit! Take up your weapon and follow me beyond these walls. Let Odin's favor land where it may.
You dare not break the king's peace here. So fuck you and your god talk. What say you to that? You can beat me, but you will not kill me. Not under Harald's truce. You are all subject to King Harald's truce.
Break his peace, and you will be cast out of Alrikstad.
I will give you no trouble. You are shed into this world without honor, Gorm, and you will leave as a turd dumped into hell's deepest ditch.
Nice.
Keep crowing, Eivor. You only make yourself an easier target.
I do want to kill him.
I should find Sigurd.
So should I have let them attack me? Because they technically would have broken the truce.
I'll put seen it beyond the map.
All right, let's see if I can grab this collectible tome first. Well, I mean, it's a key sitting in a pile of pig shit. Great. I'm getting the feeling, again, it's just because I've played Assassin's Creed games before, and I have no proof. I have zero justification for this, other than a history of how Assassin's Creed games have come before this. But something is going to happen at the Althing. And I might want to clear out the area before then. Is that just a world event or a fight? Let me see.
What is all this? Who bangs the drums of war?
Look at you! A battle-hardened Vikinger!
Oh, and what do you need?
One day, we will be the greatest warriors beneath our banner. Skulls will write songs off the wolf pack. But we must first practice our raid.
Going on a raid.
Wolfpack!
They ran. Four warriors, like four limbs of one clawing body. Each limb built to kill, destroy.
You know what? This kid's got... Kaija, was it? Kid's got attitude. Kid's bold. I give her that.
They arrived at the village. Torches, axes, and blades at the ready. Ready for the slaughter.
To war!
His insides are all outsides now.
Yeah. Yeah, this kid make a good warrior leader.
Together, the wolf pack stands in the wreckage of the enemy village. Nothing remains but frost to be taken and flaming carnage. Come.
Damn, this kid is intense.
Before your raid, leader, big wolf.
That kid just leapt. Clear, easily 15 feet. Bold as hell.
A successful raid.
Yes. With your help, we slaughtered the Raven Clan for good.
The what now?
Raven Clan, you say?
Yes. Just like Chotve Jarl's stories. One day, I'll be just like him.
Well...
Chotve's young raiders. I'll see you wolves on another battlefield one day.
I will kill you all one day. That is... morbid. A little morbid, I'm gonna be real. I mean, I don't have to see them another time. I could finish this right now. Take him out. No one would know. Oh. This is one of those games that won't let you murder children. That's a good thing. I don't know why I said it like that. That's probably a good thing. That's the one that's all the way to the north. Yeah, we're just going to do... this stuff for now. Hit up the shop, the drinking game, the rune, and this event, and or that artifact, and that's it. Right? Yeah, this game will not let you shoot a child. Good. There it is. It's another tattoo design. Because when I think artifact, I think tattoo. Got it. That's all the artifacts in this area. As of now, holders mark scheme on my arms. Underneath this house is... the pig got loose and ate the thing. The cellar key, it's your turn to dig through the shite. Let's look for an entrance to the cellar. Maybe down. Question is, we got the key, we sifted through a pile of pig crap for it. The only question is, where is the entrance and why did we sift through pig shit for this? Restock on arrows. A book of knowledge. The mark of death. That just sounds fun. All right, mark of death. Hold R2 to mark sighted enemies. Release to let a deadly volley of arrows. Cool. Auto loot is fun. It's going to take a minute to get there. Let's just... yeah, let's just do the ability to booby trap body. Oh, no, I wouldn't get that anyway. I'd do assassination damage. I do not yet have wolf-aligned armor. Even though I can hear the wolves in the distance. Yeah, well, you know, we'll prep for the body thing. Increasing my assassination damage. Oh, wait, never mind, I have two. Cool. We can now rig bodies to explode. Come on. You know I love Legend of Zelda. We gotta smash all the pots. Get one sacred orb. That's Final Fantasy. Okay. There's one wealth, one... yeah, there's a bunch of mysteries I've yet to get. And the extra wealth is all the way up there. Let's do the drinking game, hit up the shop, and then I think we're good to continue the story.
Come on, I need the challenger!
Yeah, I'll take a pre-game drink.
Ah, a thirsty foe. Sink it faster than me, you are the winner. Got a wager in you. Put your silver on the barrel. The horde it is.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, we drink.
You're going to start.
I should stumble more. Technically, I'm spilling the drink every time I stumble. All right. Easy mode. I mean, yeah.
fighting! Think you can swill with the best?
Alright, there was a shop somewhere. I just gotta find it. Food? This is the tavern where I met Sigurd. I'm fine. I'm not drunk. You're drunk. Up there's the shop. Got a little shop logo. That's how you know.
Hello, friend. Come see my wares.
Ooh.
You should always have some of these. Made with the finest ingredients. Wonderful.
Give me 200 leather.
These are locally
sourced. Give me 200 iron ore. Got a boatload. Sell all my trade.
Happy to lighten your load.
I'm gonna keep my trade goods for now. Sell that.
You be sure to always bring your stuff to me.
Nah. Those were all. I have one armor rune.
Something else?
That's it. We're
good. I must take my leave. So long.
I didn't realize I had an extra armor rune, guys. That I could finally put. Let's put the armor. These are all maxed out. Maxed out the Raven Clan set. Let's increase my axe and my iron star. Not bad. And I just need a little more iron to max that out. Cool. I need to find a blacksmith, though, to keep upgrading them further. I don't have any of the necessary materials, though, for further upgrades. I think it's nickel I need. You know what? Look, one wealth, one. Oh, that's in. Two mysteries. So this area is probably fully explorable. You just got to be careful. Because the enemies are a sight stronger than they were in Rio Velke. I remembered. Didn't even need my little cheat sheet this time to remember it. See, the fact that Harold's men are also marked as potential enemies is what's got me, like, that's a Woebringer. There's a name for it, what kind of enemy that is, which is why I'm a little bit suspicious of the man.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then you know, perhaps I have to enter the normal way. Oh, wait, unless... Damn it! Ah, well. There's King Stirborn, there's Sigurd.
Gorm still lives, Eivor.
It pains me to say. He does.
Thank you. His day will come. Oh, gods. I hate long speeches.
Only when you're not giving them.
Many of you knew my father, Halfdan the Black. A great man who achieved great things.
They buried Halfdan's leg near our temple. The crops have never grown taller.
They buried his arse near ours, and we get nothing but a muddy river.
I dream of something greater. A vast kingdom of warriors in numbers the world has never seen. United under one king, one rule. Too much blood has been spilled fighting one another. Today, we unify and turn our blades outward to conquer new lands. And who better to lead us to glory than me? I was blooded before the age of 10, and I led the greatest army Norway has ever seen. But they say a wise king seeks honest counsel, so I ask, who among you rejects this new arrangement?
I am not your enemy, King Harald, but I will not be your subject. Tomorrow, we sail for greener shores, and so my kingdom is yours.
This saddens me, noble Hjor. And does your wife agree? Is she not tired of limping ever westward?
My husband and I are as one in this, Lord. We do not limp together. We fly.
I'm sad to lose a woman of your spirit, Yuvina. But I hold no grudge. May the fates grant you good luck.
My king! I offer you my axe and my oath, ironclad.
Gorm Kjotveson, you dare show your face in this hall. Did not King Styrbjörn and his son Sigurd rid our lands of your foulness?
The Raven Clan dishonored me, great king. They poisoned my father, Kjotve. They made a mockery of his honorable death.
Back out! You lie!
Hold, Eivor. Let it play out.
This is a serious charge, Gorm, and a false one at that. My uncle saw your father die. Eivor Wolfkist, you are Kjotve's slayer. This man has slandered your clan. What shall I do with him?
I want him dead, but...
You're king of these lands, Harald. The decision must be yours.
A modest and honorable answer. Gorm, I name you Worm and call you exiled.
Worm.
Leave these lands by the next full moon, or I will feed you to the crows myself.
King Harald, may I speak?
The floor is yours, King Styrbjörn.
My people have held our land since the days when Odin himself walked among us. My kingdom is humble, but we have paid for it in blood. Our victory over Kjotve is proof that we will not lay down without a fight. All here have buried friends, brothers and sisters, sons and daughters. And I, for one, have had my fill of death. Let those who seek war look beyond our shores. If King Harald brings peace, then I am happy to bend my knee to him.
What? What in hell's name are you doing, Father?
Securing a lasting peace, Sigurd. Our days of fighting are finished.
You said nothing of this to me. Not a word. And I will not yield a title that should be mine by right.
Then war will continue. Men will die, villages will burn,
I'm actually
foolish boy.
Agreeing with Styrbjörn?
This is our only way towards true peace.
You will die a thrall. You drink addled cow. Alone and toothless in a bed of straw.
Forgive my son. He is ruled by his emotions.
I take no offense, Styrbjörn Jarl, and I thank you for your fealty. It is natural to fear change, to resist it. But all things change and all things end. The lessons of Ragnarok are clear. We will speak again soon.
That was an ambush, Lord. Did you know of Styrbjörn's plans?
For some days, yes, I did. But it was not at my urging. It was his decision alone. Do you dream of a glorious future, Eivor? A warrior like you would be a boon to my clan.
All I know of fate is that its pattern is unknowable. I do not worry beyond that fact.
I wish I understood you better. For those I do not understand, I do not trust, and I cannot stomach a lack of trust.
You have nothing to fear from me, King Harald. My loyalty lies with my brother Sigurd, and I bear you no ill will.
Then know that if you stay in Norway, both you and your brother must serve under me. Take tomorrow to think on this. But let us leave these matters for another time. Tonight, we will eat and drink like gods and wake in a kingdom made new.
All right.
Harald's colors. He's already marking his territory.
Marking? Gods, he's spraying like a horny pup.
Harald may be young, but he's clever. Do not underestimate him. He came of age very quickly.
This is our territory, right? Yeah. So he's got his colors up in our territory. He's got his men here. I just want to try getting all the treasure in that lodge that I missed. And then maybe I'll climb that mountain so I'll be able to fast travel back more easily. Up in the longhouse, so I can quick climb to the longhouse right here. And I now know how to get in because I found that entrance right there. I need to climb up, do the same thing I did last time. Only this time on purpose. So Gorm has been renamed as Worm. Is on the other side, but Let's try maybe, can I like bounce off? There you go. See this king standing around on his own. All right. Is there a? Can I go out the front door, or do I have to re-exit through the ceiling? Yeah. Things in case I ever have to come back. All right. So I'm gonna have to come back here regardless. So, you know, I don't think I'm gonna go for that wealth. I just wanna go for the synchro point because it'd be an easy quick travel point. And maybe this mystery. I guess gotta see how far it is when I get up top. Everything in there is ore. I don't get why he's so horned up for war, though. Sigurd? Like, I get it, he is a proper Viking, a proper conqueror, but he hasn't been here in years. Literally, he would get to keep doing what he's doing under Harald. He'd get to keep conquering in far-off lands. He'd probably be a high-ranking leader doing that, too. I'm crouched. Duh. Why am I running low on hunter arrows? Did I use a bunch? Nope. Not even that stone? No. Oh, wait. All right, so that area is not available. Everything beyond that is, yep, it's right there.
Can cast about this land, my friend.
So I can't get up to any of that. I can't get to that stone, that mystery, or that stone. Any of that wealth. Instead, let's mark that wealth and one of those ores and that stone. Yeah. With that, I'll be able to get a bunch of stuff. Nah, you escaped me this time, tiny bird. Renaming Gorm as Worm, that's fun. I appreciate Harold for that. Solid worm wordplay. Solid worm play. I'm still waiting for something, I guess, dramatically different in the Assassin's Creed series. I feel like that's what Black Flag was, and that's what Origins was. I think something set in ancient Japan or China would be really cool. I mean, at this point, anything set in ancient Japan is just going to be compared to Ghost of Tsushima. I feel like they missed the mark on that one. And Tsushima was a lot of fun. I never did the DLC for that, though.
What do you see, Sue?
That's all the way over there. Was I standing on top of the treasure? All right, let's just try this again. I could have swore the light was coming from inside the mountain, so that's why I did that whole run over here thing. I guess not. Ah. Leather and iron ore. Cool, 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 cool. All right. I mean, I guess I understand Sigurd's perspective, but is that how I'm going to betray Sigurd, by just realizing he's an idiot and siding with someone else? Realizing he's a fool? And that's all the synchronization points in Horde of Elke. I mean, if there was a system of like, hey, we were a Jarl, we still ruled over the land under a king. So you could still let Steerborn. I can't get to any of that area. Okay. Right, so you let Sigurd rule the land after Steerborn dies. We run the day-to-day, but you oversee the greater thing, and in the meantime, make Steerborn a high-ranking member of the raids.
What are you doing? If you wish to have words, come closer.
Our Ixtaler has a nicer field. More lived, more built up.
Gods!
Are you one of Harald's men?
I am. The king wishes to make a survey of the land he now rules. Nothing more.
Let me ask, are you one of the conquered? Did Harald take your lands as well?
No. My family has lived under his banner since the days of his father, Halfdan the Black.
Well, welcome to Thornburg, warrior.
Bunch of ungrateful Norns live here. That's how I see them. Look hard.
How are you doing, Hytham? You survived a serious blow.
I am mending. I will never be the warrior Basim wishes me to be, but I can serve my brotherhood in many other ways.
Yes, you can.
Is Kjotvei dead? You return to the south.
We are going west, in fact. Basim is a tireless crusader.
Get some rest before you set out, then. Injured men do not fare well on the open ocean.
Of course. Thank you.
But yeah, I feel like the series needs a dramatic tone shift. The trilogy of two, Brotherhood and Revelations, were both great and revolutionary. Then three started to get stale. Then they changed it up with four, and it was a huge success. Something to loot there. It was a massive success.
Can I interest you in a game of Orlok?
I've already there no way in? I have to look for Sigurd, that's right.
First, they build the man's taxes. And soon after, they will be living in our homes.
Keep your voice down, they will hear you.
Fine by me. If those backgrounds come to our door, I will carve them new shitholes.
I mean, taxes are the price we pay for living in a civilized society. Is that Thomas Jefferson?
How can I help?
I got a lot. Ooh. Let's upgrade a predator bow. Would not be a bad idea to switch up the weapons every now and then and get in play with different things. Using the Iron Hair Yar is really good. But that's its final appearance. It will never be upgradable farther than that. You know, let's upgrade my Dane axe. Have a big axe. That looks pretty cool.
Do you need anything else?
Nope.
I will free you from this bond.
And I will be ready when you need me.
It seems like people are not about this. Let's go check in with our tattoo artists. Who seem to be arguing over the same thing.
Soldiers watch me. I find it flattering.
You think one will marry you and carry you off to the capital?
Would he?
He would take his pleasure and move on, you moonlight magpie.
You heard that Harold is banning raids in all of Norway?
I did.
Does that not bother you?
If we cannot raid anyone, they cannot raid us.
Oh, a fair thought.
Welcome.
All right, nothing else to buy.
I have customers for this.
You a customer for a tooth?
I'm off. Be well, friend.
Just a tooth? There was a woman down here I could talk to. A lot of people seem to be gone. Are they all inside the longhouse? Which, you know, would make a lot of sense.
He would take his pleasure and move on, you moonlight magpie, leaving you with a little soldier to race by yourself.
Ah.
It's Eivor. Open the door.
Come in, but keep your voice down. You will alert Harald's men.
Where will we live?
The English will fight back! The wars will never end!
Or they will push us into the Christian ways!
Quiet all!
Give me a chance to speak.
Damn it.
2 days ago, we rid this land of Kjotve and his dogs. Yet today, we do not celebrate. Today we cower under a cloud of fear. But it need not be like this. We are not the heel-trodden subjects of the boy king. We are the Raven Clan. Our destiny is our own.
Did you know about your father's oath to Harald?
I did not. And for that, my anger burns hotter than any man's here. But I will not let that drive me into despair. We cannot stay in Norway. Not under Harald's boot. Not without fueling more war. So we push forward. To newer lands. To England. And there make a new home. A kingdom of our own.
The sons of Ragnar Lothbrok have been in England 8 winters already. Is there any land left for a clan of our size?
More than enough, wife. Of the 4 kingdoms of England, only one is truly pacified.
I have no desire to wear Harald's leash. I like this idea.
All right, Dag.
A saga for the ages. I agree.
It will take time and resources to build ourselves a new home, but the riches taken from Kjotve's raid would suffice.
No. That belongs to my father, as a fair compensation. In England, we must start anew.
You would start us with nothing? In a land we do not know? Among people who hate us?
Kjotve's riches would go some way to easing our passage, Sigurd. I bested him. It's within my rights to claim his goods.
Our leaving must not be an assault on my father. It is a time of renewal for us.
I mean, that makes so much sense, right? Taking the resources.
If we go, we will need all the help we can get.
I abhor such theft. But if this is what it takes...
Styrbjörn will prosper by the generosity of his new king. Chat this good.
To England, then, before the day is out. Pack what you need, but no more than that.
And tighten your lips. The last thing we need is the attention of Harald's troops.
Yeah, nothing like a mob of 30-something people keeping one secret. Totally doable.
How much did you hear?
Enough. A new path is revealed and your journey will be challenging.
Will you not join us?
For my mother's sake, I cannot. But our threads will cross again before the final day. Until then, farewell.
All right, the day grows long and turns to evening or night. Evening. This is my place. People are catting up their stuff. I'm sorry I had to disagree with you on that, buddy, but...
Welcome.
That is all I...
Fine.
Oh, it's the storyteller. Okay. Like, why am I just sitting down?
Thank you.
Is this land not filled with stuff anymore? All right.
Eivor, the wind favors us. We should set sail without delay.
You made quick work of packing. Well done.
The dream of new lands is a powerful lure,
as is the promise of glory. But the act of leaving so beloved a home, there is a sadness to it.
Having doubts?
No, not at all. The die is cast.
Then let fate guide our journey. Are you ready?
I am ready. Let us take to the water and leave unbothered while we have the
chance. That chance is past. Look!
Fate flies on swifter wings than we.
King Harald's banner.
Sigurd, what is this assembly? What are you planning?
An exit, father. As graceful as I can. For if I cannot be king in the land of my birth, I will start a new saga. In England.
Nonsense. Your place is here, son, at my side. There will be other victories soon. Other glories.
My choice is made, father. Do not hope otherwise. There's nothing for me here. I must go make my name in the world.
So Steerborn rode in on Harald's banner.
And you have plundered Fornberg's resources, I see. You leave nothing behind but your honor.
You left me no choice. I entered the Alving a prince. I left the son of a Jarl.
There are always choices, Sigurd. I will not stand between you and yours, but I... 17. I should have left you to...
Sad old elk. Do not carry his words with you to England. He brought this day upon himself.
I know.
Supplies 600 and raw materials 20. So that number probably would have been lower. All right. Sigurd, Bragi, Dag. Tattoo people. I think that's the horsewoman. I don't see his wife. That is it. No one else comes with us. All right. Oh, I guess all these people are in their longboats. That's the king's.
The time for tears is over, you weeping sacks of wool.
Put some muscle into those pulls.
Ration your strength, Mark. We have an ocean to cross.
All right, you lazy backrouts. Sigurd, what's our course?
The sons of Ragnar established a settlement near the coast. We set sail for them.
Whoa.
Sing a song to lift our hood.
To rouse the gods! Inspire a mighty fart from Thor to speed us on our way!
So we got a couple other boats coming.
The ocean lies before us, Eivor. And on its far side, a new kingdom awaits.
You know England well from your travels.
I spent the season in their kingdom of Mercia, a temperate land. Lush and wild. By now, the sons of Ragnar will have claimed its heart.
Do we mean to join their army?
They will join ours. In time, all of England will know of Raven Clan and the glory we brought to that fractured land. So to England! Glory,
Amelia?
And destiny!
To England!
To England!
Or Valhalla!
Well, preferably England first. All right. Assassin's Creed Valhalla. So that was our prologue. That was our game opener. Four playthroughs. Four two-hour sessions was our opening introduction to the game. And I... Oh, hey, we're playing as a... What's her name? Back in modern times. Oh, yay, we're still doing this. All right. Short. I'm curious as to the history of... what this is. Oh, wow. Popping pills. When are they going to set the modern Assassin's Creed game already? When are they going to do that? Abstergo versus whatever's left of the Assassins. And that's the spear I got from the DLC at the very end of Assassin's Creed Odyssey, the Atlantis thing. Were we just staring at that for a while? Popping in your earbuds.
In a lecture at the University of Cambridge, Dr. Sirka told a worried audience that scientists have few answers for them.
Since the mass coronal ejection of 2012, the strength of the Earth's magnetic field has increased by a factor of 50,000.
Goddamn.
This has resulted in huge disturbances in radio and satellite communications, dangerous bands of radiation around the poles, and as we can all see from our window, an aurora borealis that never burns away. Unfortunately, we are stumped as to why this is happening, and if we cannot find an answer soon, it may change the way we live, the way we communicate, even the way we evolve forever.
Dr. Sirka went on to say,
"Bought you more electrolytes."
Hey, Sean, how you doing?
New and improved citrus flavor.
Ah, Sean looks...
Thanks, Sean.
Different. So we got the last origins. With the new modern animus, we no longer need genetic memory.
How do we fix this? How are you the key to everything?
Because 1 through 4 were all the genetic memory, and I think, I don't remember, I never did Unity or Syndicate. I just had no desire to do Unity or Syndicate. Origins, we used Bayek's body with the new and improved animus. We no longer need genetic memory. We need a DNA sample. And all of Odyssey was obtained from the blood on the end of a spear. That's Eivor's body. Well, it was not buried in a temple. I was buried in a field, but with my shield and sword at my side. Got a lot of plastic lawn chairs overlooking.
It's beautiful, but it's not normal.
I mean, that. Is what I was clearly looking at. Yeah. Are these the fields of England or are these the hills of Norway? We got windmills. Let's go tilt at them. A little campsite.
I should do this more often. Relaxing.
I don't remember. What was my name? The main character's name of the first 5 games? Why am I blanking on his name? Declan...
I'm not going anywhere. Not yet.
Oh, God. Why am I blanking on his name? What? What?
Another satellite. Damn.
Oh, that's a common occurrence. Never mind. There's a satellite falling. We got the American flag up. Are we in America? Did Eivor make... I mean, a number of Vikings did make it across the ocean. Vikings, aside from the indigenous peoples, Vikings were the first to discover America years before Columbus and his...
I'd rather walk into town than use this.
There were stories of Vikings all along the eastern coast of America, too. Not just in Canada, in Northern America.
We'd love to play around, but I have bigger things on my mind.
I don't remember any of Layla's companions from the previous games. Again, I don't...
Did you get my tea?
Rebecca, that was it.
Some quality stuff here.
Rebecca.
Oof. Mint tea is not actually tea, Bex. It's an infusion. It's really just dirty minty water.
I don't care what you call it, Sean. Did you buy any?
Of course I did, love.
Hey, sorry about pulling you out. The generator was sputtering.
That's fine. I needed air.
How is the Animus data stream? Comfortable?
Felt pretty stable after a while.
Good. Just give me a sec, and you can jump back in.
For this one, we're using Eivor's corpse.
Another satellite came down. Did you see?
I did. One of Abstergo's.
That's good.
Well, most of North America just lost its GPS service, so depends what you mean by good, really.
Right. Even when we win, we lose.
Okay, well,
Sergio has its fingers
whenever
in everything.
You're ready, you can jump back in.
So what big tech company is Abstergo heralding? Is it Google? Is it Apple?
Go for it. Cool.
That's quite nice. Soothing. Let's have a look.
You know, there's a lot of stuff. The Isu messengers. Isu, that's what they were called. I reviewed the logs from my time as Bayek and came across some old notes. In the years I explored Cleopatra's Egypt, I stumbled across 6 Isu temples. Yeah, I 100% of that game, so I had a lot of stuff from the Isu there. I am in pain. The Staff of Eden, the Staff of Hermes, Trismegistus. Acquired from the Eagle Bear Cassandra in 2018, because Cassandra is an immortal, yes. Presumed manufacture date late in the Isu Singularity. The Staff, one of many Isu staves, known to us as first and foremost a medical device, with the ability to heal, repair, and restore and rejuvenate organic tissues with unprecedented swiftness. It has been known to extend the life of bears well beyond the average human and Isu lifespans, and is presumed to have the ability to resuscitate living creatures in critical or suspended states. It has not been verified if the staff has the ability to resurrect the dead, but it seems unlikely based on its known features. It appears to work by reading and copying its bear's DNA signature to ensure perfect replication on a broad scale. It is able to detect erroneous copies and deploy repairs, so long as the bear remains within direct contact. It has been used as a weapon infrequently, possibly by taking advantage of the tremendous power it draws from Isu's wireless energy lattice. The staff has also acted as a conduit or container for the personality of an Isu called Alethea. It is not known if the personality of Alethea's original consciousness or the simulation of the original, though most neuroscientists would call this a distinction without a difference. As of early 2019, the entity known as Alethea has made no further attempts to contact me, and yet my purpose as the so-called heir of memories as Alethea has dubbed me remains unclear. Known bears, Hermes Trismegistus, Pythagoras, and Cassandra. My stuff. To Layla, you have a gift and a curse, the gift of old blood, a curse you know of not understanding it. We can help you. What you did is not your fault, but... But your favorite team happened to be the Atlantis Eagles. Good. I'm ready. One last message. After which all communication between us via this account or any other method will cease. And it is a heck of a message. My colleagues tell me your initial meeting went well. They're impressed. Aware of influence, air of memories, and the weeks, times. But take this to heart. The world is sick and getting sicker. The Earth's magnetic field is growing stronger. Satellites are flooding the sky. Earthquakes are getting more frequent. Famines are becoming more and more frequent. And now we have credible reports of a new deadly virus sweeping through Asia. Well, it feels like we're living through a Yeastian nightmare. A Yeatsian nightmare, sorry. Mere anarchy is loose upon the world. In many ways, there's a hope to cure us. Rami. Layla, I don't like where you're not using phones. My number is just you call it. And now I won't say hello to our parents for you because... doing so would bury me in questions I cannot answer, and Father no longer work for Abstergo would break his heart. It's all he ever talks about, how his daughter's on the cutting edge of neuroscience. The man doesn't understand the first thing about what you do or did, and he's still proud. That COVID. So COVID exists in this world. Okay. Is that why you're cagey? Something else? Call him, call me, stop us and say game, hide and seek. We give this short email I wanted to call, but I'm not using phones right now. Time is limited. I'm still recovering from my trip. Things got out of hand, nothing is expected, people got hurt, I told you it was for research, and it was, but not for Abstergo. The truth is, I haven't worked for them for a few years, but it's a long story, I won't bother with details, but also for me, leave it at that. The group I'm with now, I can't explain, not over email, but they've shown me things, given me opportunities, that my eyes took water for you, but not without cost. In fact, I fucked up last year, bad, one more thing I need to make right, I know this sounds cryptic, but I'm not endangered. I don't want any DNA sniffers picking up on keywords that might raise alarms, do some paranormal, here's the point. Don't worry about me. I'm with a couple of people who I trust now. They've been at this longer than I have. Yes, they have. They've been at this since the beginning. And this time next year, things will be better. Skies will be clear. Earthquakes will stop. And we'll celebrate Ramadan together, just like in the 90s. Tell Mama and Baba I miss them. Your sister. Thanks for clearing that up in such profound detail. I'm sure I'll sleep soundly now. And I don't have COVID now. And I'm well isolated. It's just the three of us traveling together, staying out of sight. All right. The Hidden Ones more accurately operated in the Roman Britain from the years 100 to 430 CE, the Common Era. We don't know. What we do know is that several hundred years before the Hidden Ones returned to the island, it may be Bassem and Haitham are the first in half a century. There were six bureaus operating in the Roman period. Leicestershire, London, Winchester, York, Essex, and Gloucestershire. These won't be the Saxon names, so you'll have to read between the lines. Animus anomalies. There are 10 embedded in the simulation, pieces of Eden. We don't know if any Isu artifacts you should be looking for specifically. That's a lot. I'm not reading that.
I lived. I died. And now I sleep. And in my sleep, I dream. And in my dreams, I see an end to the doom that will grip the earth once again. Find the Wolfkist. Find the Mad One. Find me. And save us all from another death.
A strange message is broadcast from an unknown source north of the Arctic Circle. The message was broadcast for 9 days, then ceased. Spectrum analysis of the message revealed coordinates to a Norse gravesite in New England, USA. So we are in the US. Message from Sean to Layla.
Layla, thought you might be interested in this. Conversations that Bex and I had with Desmond back in 2012. December, I think. Just, candid talks, that's all. We didn't square any circle, any beat poetry, but he did have some interesting insights into his time in the Animus and what it means to be an assassin. Anyway, have a listen. You might find you and he had similar experiences, so, well, let me know what you think. Unless it's to tell me I sound like a total prat in these recordings. If that's the case, just say nothing. I mean, I did have a slight cold at the time I recorded these. That's probably why I sound odd. Anyway,
Gotcha. Was it a different voice actor? Is that the excuse?
No, no. Come on, Sean. Turn that thing off. Oh, hold on. I like what you said there.
Sam,
I want to get this for posterity. Say it again, nice and loud. Seriously? Sure, come on. If nothing else, it'll give me leverage with your old man.
Ah, that's your angle. Nice. What I said was, I wish I hadn't been born into the Assassins. I wish I had chosen this life. Is that good enough?
Sure, but why is that?
Because choice is the central idea of our creed. It underpins everything, right? It's about free will. It's about seeing the evidence before you and saying, yes, this is what I want. Or, no, this isn't for me. But when you're born into a group like this, or any other, like I was, you get mixed signals. You get told over and over again, this is what we believe. These are the rules. This is reality. No deviation. And if you question it, oh, they look at you like you killed a puppy. That's hardly free will. It's a weird irony when free will is your central belief, but nobody wants you to believe otherwise. I don't know how to say it exactly.
That's an interesting take on that.
There's something self-destructive about our creed. If free will is the most important moral guidepost we have, we should be free to ignore it. To choose submission, for example. You know what I mean? We should be free to side with the Templars. If it's really my choice, I could do that.
Right. It's almost self-refuting. A democracy could democratically elect a dictator or choose to get rid of democracy altogether. Within our creed is the seed of its own destruction. That's what makes it powerful, I think. And fragile.
Right, right. The more freedom you have, the more risky it is, you know? Anyway, my dad has mellowed over the years, but he was strict when we lived on the farm.
Desmond prevented the apocalypse in 2012. That's right.
I never got the impression that I was free to choose my path forward. Our creed, our tenets, they were drilled into my head. By the time I was a teenager, I was following these rules out of a sense of duty. This was just what we did.
That happens to a lot of organizations over time. Stagnation sets in, you know? A fundamentalism.
Yeah. Following the rules becomes more important than achieving whatever goal you set out for yourself. And people start to lose sight of the reason the rules exist.
That's called deontology, or a form of it. Following a rule for its own sake, and not for the consequences it has.
Yeah, but that feels backwards, doesn't it?
Well, I think so. Following a rule is the easy part. Praying, taking a sip of wine, munching on a wafer. Rituals that give comfort.
But that's just going through the motions. It makes people feel like they're doing something. When the hard work is, well, actually getting off your ass and doing something productive.
Preach. I deal with that all the time. That's tight huge. Boundaries.
They want to see the four walls that pen them in.
I don't disagree.
Anything outside that? Anything that makes life more complex? That's scary. That's why I envy you. You chose this life. You went through that process, and you decided, yes, I believe in this.
Sure. It didn't stop me from being an insufferable know-it-all as a teenager, but I see your point.
I would have loved to have been a know-it-all. I knew nothing. Not until you guys found me. Yeah. It wasn't until I met you, Bex, and Lucy, that I knew. I knew I wanted to be an assassin.
Oh, thanks, Des. Come here. Bring it in, bud. I don't normally like
I'm still shit. Bummed that they killed Lucy. I get it. Kristen Bell was getting very famous and it was probably getting very pricey to keep her around. But.
Hold on, I'll just set this here.
Do you guys record everything we talk about?
Not everything.
But you've been using the Animus so much, I thought this was a good chance to learn some things.
So this is the Animus song. Exposure. That was just an interesting talk on deontology.
No.
And the concept of free will.
The Animus was too much for them to handle.
Cute.
Can I ask you about the bleeding effect? Any recent flashes? Any memories resurfacing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the usual things. Ghost images of Altair and Ezio a few times a day. Nothing intrusive, just brief moments. They pass quickly, almost without me noticing. Like a figure in the corner of my eye.
So this is before 3.
From the night before. I did have one extended hallucination a few days ago. It was Ezio. He was older, around the time he left Cappadocia. He was standing on the deck of a ship, alone. And through him, I could feel an intense regret or guilt. And it felt to me like he'd had a loss of faith in himself, in the creed, like he couldn't keep it up, couldn't stay true to his ideals. And as I watched him, I thought, is this the moment he decided he was done being an assassin? It felt like it. Anyway, most of my visions have been brief, lasting just a few seconds. They're like complete memories of small moments that appear suddenly out of nowhere, fully formed. It's a strange feeling.
Okay, anything else?
I'm starting to see Connor now, too.
Oh, so this is during 3, never mind.
I hear his voice more often than I see him. I'm sure that will change. Oh, yeah, and yesterday, just before bed, I had a memory of being on a beach in the Caribbean with a bunch of sailors. Or maybe they were pirates. I don't know. No idea.
Huh. I'll look into that. And how do you feel?
There you go.
In general?
So even though he didn't actively dive into the memories of, I forget the name of the main character from 4,
strangely comforting.
He started having them bleed into himself.
Memories and skills and thoughts of so many people. I feel like I've lived a few hundred years or more. Is it possible that if I do this for too long, it'll push my own memories aside? That I'll be everyone but myself after a while?
It's possible. That's called identity substitution. It's happened before, but it's rare. And someone with your background shouldn't need to worry.
My background?
Hmm.
You mean someone with my genes? My abilities?
You have Isu DNA, and that lets you see things and do things and withstand traumas that other people can't.
And I can suffer in ways that others can't.
Hmm.
That's not something to be proud of.
You mean the apple?
Yeah. It has a pull, Bex. It tugs at my brain. It talks to me. Teases me. Drives me mad. And what I did to Lucy. God damn it. Nothing is worth the damage I did. The pain I caused.
I know. But you're special. That's the point.
I'm not special, Bex. I'm lucky. That's all.
I understand.
We're assassins. It's our creed that makes us different, not our genes, not our blood. Anyone can join us.
That's true. But let's leave that aside for a second. What I want to know is, have you ever had any Isu memories resurface?
Isu memories? I don't think so. I can't even begin to imagine what that would feel like.
I think you'd know if you did. Maybe one day, we might be able to induce something.
Jesus, let's fix the world first, okay? Before we start digging up my ancient ancestors.
Deal.
With my luck, I'll be related to some third-rate Isu like Sisyphus or something.
Way to aim high, buddy.
Hey, you gotta.
All right. I was a friend and colleague of Victoria's, both at Abstergo and in her subsequent freelance careers, and all the time I knew she probably had the most intelligence. Yeah. File corrupted. All right.
I went through hell to bring you here. It had better be worth it. Sean has been busy.
That's the sound file we heard.
Hello, Layla.
Sean has aged.
What do you make of the grave out there?
Well, it overturns a few hundred years of scholarship about the first Europeans to set foot in North America. Apart from that, it's just a bunch of muddy bones, isn't it?
Can we talk about this thing on my neck for a second?
Ah, the mood stabilizer.
It's not harmful, is it? I mean, I feel good, but I want to make sure there's no side effect.
There shouldn't be. It's only blocking outside signals, a passive effect, so the staff doesn't, you know, mess with you.
Sean, what happened last year, I had no control over that. I tried to resist.
I understand. And your old team, maybe they don't. But we've seen that sort of thing before. Still, if you want to work with us and get to the bottom of why the world is about to end for the second time in 8 years, then you wear that thing until we say otherwise. William's orders.
I know.
It's just a few more weeks, yeah?
You're right.
All right. So this mood stabilizer prevents
you
me
put
from...
put this in the fridge, Sean?
Of course. In half a minute.
Remember, tomatoes go on the counter, not the fridge. Please enjoy your stay. Remember, all the garbage must be packed out, and please water the plants once a day. Yeah, I won't remember that. Sean, don't forget to water the plants while I'm under, okay?
I'll add it to the calendar and tattoo it on my leg.
My jump started the end of the world.
Feeling okay?
Better. But I'm worried that it could happen again. The two data streams.
I can't promise it won't. I barely understand it myself.
It felt like two minds.
Fight. Right. There's something about this Viking's DNA sample that feels dense. Noisy.
Could it be the staff?
How do you mean?
My headaches. My temper. They started the day I got that thing.
I hope you're not making excuses for, you know, your friend.
Jesus, no. I'm not.
Sorry. Just take it.
I'm trying. Be nice to sleep in a real bed when this is over.
All right. Back in we go.
All right. Time to go. Norway to England takes about a week by long ship, so I'll scrub ahead.
You mean we don't get to play a full week on just open ocean?
Layla, you okay?
Sorry. Can you play the message again?
We have the transcript. If you're looking for something, I can
go
and...
No, I want to hear it.
Okay.
I don't mean to be cryptic. It's just... That message led us here, to this place, to a Norse grave in North America. Mm-hmm. So those bones out there are the only lead we have. Our only chance at fixing this planet before it's too late.
Here it is.
I lived. I died. And now I sleep. And in my sleep, I dream. And in my dreams, I see an end to the doom that will grip the earth once again. Find the Wolfkist. Find the Mad One. Find me. And save us all from another death.
Unsettling, that is.
So we found the Wolfkist.
That pulse in the message. Are you sure it's just coordinates? Nothing else?
Nothing I can find.
All right.
Okay, I'm ready.
Here we go.
Maybe I should refresh myself off screen about what happened in the other games with Layla. And here we are. Let's open this game. Oh, see, look at this color palette. It pops so much more. England, 873 CE. Already more oranges, more yellows, more greens, brighter blues. Looks so much better already.
There she is. England, our new home.
Not a patch on Norway.
but we'll make this land our own soon enough.
I'm glad to see any land at all. And will be happy to have my feet on solid ground again.
We must not rush our landing. All you see here is Saxon territory. The Kingdom of Mercia, largely unpacified. There will be eyes watching us from the trees, with bows drawn and traps set. We must be wary.
Randi! Dig in your oars! All standing!
Have you spotted something?
Not yet. Well, let us go ahead to clear the path of any dangers. Then follow our lead when the sun brushes the horizon.
Understood! May Thor bless you all on your way! We will see you soon!
Sail on!
Yes!
The Swan Road home.
For whatever these green-thumbed fairy folk have to throw at us.
Sigurd, do the sons of Ragnar know that we're coming?
They do not, or they will not scoff at our visit. Of the four kingdoms in England, the sons of Ragnar have settled only one. Mm-hmm. The rest is ripe for the taking.
Do we mean to join their army?
No. We will speak with them. Get the lay of the land, and carve this country into as many pieces as we see fit.
Look ahead there! Is that what passes for a town? Plain brick and a single rune to their timid god?
That rune is called a root, Dag. The cross upon which their god was sacrificed. It sits atop a monastery, a place of worship.
That cross killed their Christ, and now they display it in worship? Bizarre.
We carve idols of our gods and make wishes before them. Like our sacrifices to Odin, the One-Eyed.
Mm-hmm. But we do not worship the wolf that kills him. That is the difference.
Whatever strangeness we see in these Saxons, they must think the same of us.
The hammer! Now there is a symbol worthy of a god. A bolt of lightning would take that cross clean off. Look there! What are they doing?
Ritual drowning.
Baptism, Dad. Are the ways of Christians really so unfamiliar to me?
Not at all. I simply forgot. And someone has to keep the conversation up.
Baptism?
There must be priests and worshippers alone in that place. We could storm this port with ease. Sack it without breaking a sweat.
Is there much in the way of treasure there?
Always! They shape precious metals and cut jewels to their gods. There will be a fortune there.
Later, Dag. There will be time enough for raiding once we have settled.
This whole area looks like a pretty peaceful monastery.
Come to. Stop the boats. Pull up over there. The way forward is blocked by a chain spanning the river. We must remove it before passing on.
Gotcha. Okay.
Can we cut through it?
It's too thick for access. But there must be a way to release it somewhere in that camp.
I will go.
And I will be right behind you.
No, Dad. You stay here. Should trouble come our way, I want you defending the ship.
A good idea. Send out the arrow and keep your sharpest axe at hand, huh?
Something like that.
Come on. Up and at him. Where was the other auto looting? Breakfall is really good for one, two, three, four, or one, two, three, four, five. Get the stealth recon, but I don't waste my thing on something like the Way of the Wolf, which I don't have wolf armor yet. Um, said, let's improve my range. And that automatically unlocked ability. Oh, no. It went from there to there. Okay, I gotcha. But it opened this whole area for me. Okay, that's understandable then. All right, we're going to try a big axe. So I think this is going to be the last thing we're going to do. We're going to do one thing here in the land of England. Actually, first thing I want to do... See? Northumbria, Mercia, Wessex. London. See, now this is a map, right? All of these are different areas and different territories. Raids. That. A zealot. So that's the monastery I passed, and there's wealth all along this area. Raspberries instead of cloudberries. Now, you know what? Also, let's...
I want to be cautious around here.
His nose and screaming supplication, playing bad spirits with tormented. They had a whole horse hanging from a tree.
1, 2, 3.
Been there a while too. Disgusting.
There it is. All right, so it's R1. Come on. So aim lower than you would think, but higher than you... So I don't draw it back. Gotcha. The river chain, after conducting several trials, we found that these naval chains will hold against even the most durable of Danish longships. So long as the mechanism remains intact, several more blockades will be constructed in the coming months and installed at rivers of England, best defense against forthcoming incursions. Gotcha.
This chain is huge and poorly anchored, it appears. I might be able to shoot it.
All right. Hey, I didn't realize there was a guy up here. My bad.
The path is clear.
Chain is away. Hang on. Back to the boat.
We should be close. Barring any more surprises.
All right.
I say we go back, Sigurd. Give those dogs a good knock around and take whatever treasures they have. Easy pickings.
Not today, Dad.
I mean, there's a lot of treasure there. So we're settling somewhere in Mercia.
Until we reach our goal, we cannot afford another surprise. Now be on your guard. It should not be far.
Gods, I'm ravenous. I hope they have food and ale on hand when we arrive. You should have sent word ahead of us, Sigurd, to get something on the spit.
If Havdan, Ubba, and Ivar Ragnarsson are lacking food in England, then all of us will starve. Have no worry.
Ah, I can see it now.
A suckling, look at that temple in the background.
And juicy, and the ale as gold as the treasures that we failed to steal back there.
A man of simple pleasures, aren't you, Dak?
And he is happier for it. For my part, I look forward to standing in the footsteps of the giants that built this land.
What giants?
The great Romans and their empire. Giants of a forgotten age. They held dominion here long ago, and their ruins dot the landscape. Every brick and stone tells a story of conquest and glory. And now, they are rubble and ash.
To be remade! We will rebuild their empire, brick by brick.
Yep, the Roman Empire was truly massive.
All things end, Og. Ruins are not a warning. They are a testament. Look there, just ahead, where the sons of Ragnar make their camp.
At last, to find our feet on steady ground.
Sigurd, hold back. Something isn't right.
Good eye. There's too little movement for an army. Only tents and a few men.
Not the army we hope to find?
No. Let us get a closer look.
Maybe they're out raiding? Or have they been killed?
Those are not Norsemen.
Grantabrig is Shire.
We should proceed on foot, lest they spot the boats.
Dag and I will go together.
We all go. If they are friends, I wish to meet them as a young. And if they are foes, then we fight them all together.
Ragnarsson's encampment.
Who are these men?
They speak with twisted accents. English, no doubt.
Dark, Eivor! Hey, on me!
Come on, up and at him. This is our first interaction in England.
Oi, what's this? A mess of filthy Danes befouling our riverways? You there? Give us your name.
I am Sigurd Jarl of Fornberg, and you are...
Men who do not take kindly to Dane invaders creeping into our camp. You'd best move along, pagan. Spare yourselves a slaughter.
You threaten Norsemen with a play of swords and expect us to cower?
I have been 8 days at sea without a drop of blood to wet my axe. So spare the chatter, Buckrout, and draw your weapon.
Oh! Let's finish them!
Kill these evil bastards!
You have what you wished for, Jack.
It feels like home already!
Bloody coward!
Alright, so it's like slower attacks, but they hit way harder. Oh man, there's a lot of these guys. Are they throwing dust at us? What's going on here?
Right. I will check the longhouse.
So it is a Vikinger camp held by the English. Stuff there. One. These are all rations. Gotcha. So the small axes have quick, powerful blows. This has a slow build-up, but it hits hard. See. Is that Sigurd?
Eivor, look at this.
A noise trap. Might be something inside. I will have a look.
Wait. Who are you? Are you with those brigands as well?
Sigurd, Dag, in here. Those men had prisoners.
You there, untie us. Let us walk and we will not hurt you.
Quite bold in those bindings. I like your spirit.
We are very agreeable people, I promise. You need not kill us.
Peace, friend. We have no need or wish to hurt you. What are your names?
Yenli. I'm a merchant, not a bandit like those others. And this is Rowan.
Rowan, that's right. I'm a stable hand, that's all. I keep horses and, well, I did. Till those brigands sold them off.
They meant to sell us next, as slaves to the nearest bidder.
Yanli and
but
Rowan.
I ripped their eyes out before I let that happen.
And how did you find yourselves here?
We came to trade with the Sons of Ragnar, at Halfdan Jarl's asking. But they were gone when we arrived.
Unbind them. You know the Sons of Ragnar?
Aye. Sold many a mare and stallion to the brothers. Good men. Always paid me fair.
From the look of this camp, they've been gone for some time. Where will you go now? What will you do?
Join us.
Take me, Festox. Start anew. I have friends and allies across the land to aid me. But it won't be easy.
Every town and village needs a stable to keep horses fit and trim. I'll find my footing again. Somewhere.
All right.
I think we have our
first English recruit.
We could use their skills as we get settled. Having access to trade and someone to tend our mounts would be a boon.
My thoughts as well. Any friend of the Ragnarsons is a friend of mine. Right, Dag?
Whatever you think is best, Sigurd.
Yanli, Rowan, I am Sigurd Jarl of Thornberg, son of Styrbjörn. This is Eivor and Dag. Both of you are free to go, but more than welcome to stay if you're willing to pull your weight.
We'd be happy to, if only to get back on our feet.
All right.
Then let it be done. The Raven Clan welcomes you.
All right, we got some allies. We have a footing.
From strangers into friends into family. The others have arrived. Come.
I have a good feeling about this place.
Honored family, friends, welcome to your new home.
This is going to be our new home? All right. Hey, building's already built. We got a pre-built colony here. Or tent's pre-built. I guess the longhouse is pre-built, but that's kind of it. I didn't see a single horse on those ships. Where did we get a horse? Not a bad looking little camp. It's not the most defendable or fortifiable, but I assume that'll come with time. I'm hoping, oh god, which one was it? Was it two or Brotherhood where you got to build and improve your camp, the Auditory home? I hope it's more like that.
Now come. Randvi has found something I would like you to see.
Eivor, Sigurd, I give you England and its four kingdoms. Mercia, East Anglia, Northumbria, and Wessex. From the few plans and maps I discovered here, I believe the sons of Ragnar have pushed further into Mercia, here. My scouts will soon tell me if I am correct.
And where are we?
Here. And this unnamed copse of trees.
Unnamed? We cannot let that stand. What will we call this place?
I might have an idea. Ravensthorpe, the village of ravens.
All right.
I like it. The poet in you sings once again. One day, this name will be known throughout all of England.
A name is only a beginning. If we want renown, we must build. Expand.
Cool.
Agreed. We should begin with a forge. Can you help Gunnar get working again?
We'll need cargo, supplies.
For that, our neighbors will provide, whether they wish to or not.
Scarcely arrived, and now we must raid.
We cannot master this land merely by asking.
I'll go and speak with Gunnar now.
Good work. The ability to make Atlas, travel overseas to different countries, use the Atlas. Alright, so I can travel back and forth from Norway to England. Cool. Ravensthorpe as an encampment is 1 out of 6. Cool. And there's a lot in this area. A raid will lead to growth in wealth and stuff for our settlement.
Cool. It's mostly scraps of plans, old letters, a few runestone messages. It took some time to decipher the mess and piece it all back together.
So, I wonder, personally, are we going to re-encounter Basim and Hytham at some point? Why can't I? Come on. No? Alright, maybe I just can't use it yet. You know what? Before we continue, we are here in England. This waterfall is a fresh source of water. That's good. This land looks beautiful. But I think, guys, that is where we are going to end for today, about 2.5 hours. And we have just finished this beginning. So, thank you so much for joining me. I think if you're watching this on Twitch, give me a follow. If you're watching on YouTube, like, comment, subscribe. Check out some of the other playlists I've done. Releasing right around this time should be more... We should be wrapping up Guardians of the Galaxy and Kena Bridge of Spirits on YouTube. And beginning The Pathless. And we are also doing some Pokemon Brilliant Diamond. So, check out those streams. And hopefully by now, when this goes live on YouTube, I will also have started Deathloop. So check that out. But for now, that's going to be what I call it. So I will see you guys until next time.